हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू क्लास 7 सब्जेक्ट मैथ चैप्टर प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस। एंड टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट विद द सम बेसिक डेफिनेशंस। दैट इज कॉस्ट प्राइस, द प्राइस एट विच द एन आर्टिकल इज परचेस्ड इज कॉल्ड। सो परचेस्ड प्राइस इज एक्चुअली called cost price. Then we can write this one as a CP also. So note that some note we have to remember: the overhead expenses like sales tax, labor charges, cartages, etc. are included in the cost price. Suppose you have brought something as a second hand, you bought it from someone and you need to some repair of that vehicle or anything, so that cost also will be included in the cost price. So that is the note here. Now selling price, which is also written as SP, and we can say the price at which an article is sold, the sold price of an article, sold price of an article, sold price of an article is called selling price. Now next is profit or gain. So how do you understand that you have profit if your selling price is more than your cost price? Then you can say, then seller has a gain or profit. Now suppose selling price is SP and cost price is CP, so gain will be SP minus CP. And if you want to find out gain percentage, so then that will be with respect to the cost price. That means cost price will be in denominator and gain will be in numerator, multiply by 100 and give percentage symbol outside of it. Similarly, if you have loss by selling something, then how do you know that thing? So to know that, first you have to subtract, you have to check your selling price and cost price. If your cost price is more than selling price, or you have sold anything less than your purchased price, so then you have to understand that you have loss in your that item. So then seller has a loss. So similar way we will find loss percentage also. So to find out the loss percentage, first you need to find loss. So what is the formula of loss? That is CP minus SP. So if you want to find out the loss percentage with respect to your cost price, so write down the loss in numerator and cost price in denominator, then multiply by 100 and give percentage symbol. So this formula will give you loss percentage. So now some relevant formula that will help us to do this chapter So first we will keep in mind that gain percentage equal to gain by CP into 100, then percentage symbol. Now one thing I want to tell you, that if someone want to find out, that gain, when gain percentage is given, CP is given. Suppose let CP and gain percentage is given, these two are given, you have to find out gain here. So how do you find out? So from this equation, just we multiply here, and suppose if you do the cross multiplication, so you will get gain equal to CP into gain percentage by 100. So this will give you gain percent, gain from the gain percentage. Okay, similarly, if you want to find out CP, so CP also possible to calculate from it. If you want to find out SP, so first I am writing some formula which is helpful for us to solve the problems. Suppose we have to find out SP, and it is given. And how this formula came, that one also we will see. And after that, without any remembering, you can make your formula yourself. So suppose you need to find out SP when gain percentage and CP is given. Suppose you need to find out SP again when loss percentage is given. When loss percentage is given and your CP is given. Suppose you have to find out CP when your gain percentage and SP is given. So this will be 100 by 100 plus gain percentage. We will see how this formula came. That one also will be discussed here just now. So please first try to see all the formula, and if it is possible to remember, you can keep remember also. So first what we have seen, we seen that if 100 SP selling price is what? CP plus gain. And we already know CP plus gain is selling price. Similarly, you can say what is SP if you have loss. So CP minus loss. CP minus loss. Here CP is more than SP. So first I want to discuss that how this formula came, gain percentage. So if C is cost price is CP, then gain is this one. And if cost price is 1 rupees, then gain is gain by CP. If cost price is 100 rupees, so with respect to 100 rupees, we are finding the gain. So that will be the gain percentage. So this is the gain percentage. Similarly, if you write loss percentage, this formula, that is loss into loss by CP into 100 and percentage symbol. So this how we got? We have done loss when CP cost price is C into P, then we have done loss LOSS. When cost price is 1 rupees, then we have done loss by C into P, CP. And when cost price is 100 rupees, then we have done loss, that is loss by CP into 100 and the percentage symbol. So this is the loss percentage. So with respect to 100 rupees, how much we have done loss, that is the loss percentage. And now we will see that from this, if you want to find out, suppose gain percentage equal to gain by CP into 100 and percentage symbol. So gain percentage we know. So if you want to find out SP, SP means what? SP means CP plus gain. And if you find gain from here, so what you will get? You will get here gain percentage or profit percentage into CP by 100. Now we have to add this gain percentage. So students, we have seen gain equal to gain percentage into CP by 100. Now CP is also here and here also, so we can take from these two terms CP. So what will remain? 1 plus gain percentage by 100. And if you do the sum of this fraction, so what you will get? You will get 100 plus gain percentage by 100. So we should look once our given formulas. So what was the given formula here? SP equal to 100 plus gain percentage into divided by 100 into CP. And please look at here also, here we also get SP equal to CP into 100 plus gain percent by 100. So this is the formula by which, this is the process to find the formula also. So if you forgot only one formula you remembered, so that will also help you to find the other formula. Now we will look at that another formula, that is SP by the use of loss percentage. So we know that loss means CP minus SP, and loss means CP minus SP. So we need to find out here SP. So that is loss. So SP will be here CP minus loss. And we already know the formula of loss percentage, that is loss by CP into 100 percentage. Okay, so from this we can get loss also. Loss will be CP into loss percentage, CP into loss percentage by, so loss equal to CP into loss percentage by 100. Now put this value here. So CP minus CP into loss percentage by 100. So if you take common CP from this both two terms, so you will get CP into 1 minus loss percentage by 100. So finally you got here CP into 100 minus loss percentage divided by 100. So this is the required formula, which already we have seen in formula chart. that SP equal to 100 minus loss percentage was 100 into CP. So students, I think you have understood how to derive this formula from one known formula. You can derive other unknown formulas. So thank you. Have a nice day. Next day we will do some more things on this chapter.